Let me start with the single child. As you know, look around and see, the size of the family is continuously coming down. On the one side, of course, the joint family concept is slowly giving way to nuclear family, particularly in urban areas and big cities like Bangalore, where it's difficult. And people who are in continuously transferable jobs, one day they're going away to USA, one day they take up a job in Gurgaon, things like that. So what is happening is that you can't live together, so it's becoming a nuclear family. The other is, as I mentioned to you also earlier, the number of children. Probably your parents, grandparents had half a dozen or more siblings, and then we came down to 3, 4, and now it has come down to either 1 or 2. Isn't it? If you look around all the young couples that you know in your social circles, you will find people with either 1 child or with 2 children. Okay. Now what happens if there is a single child? I want to make it firstly clear that I am not passing judgment. I am not saying that it is good to have more than 1 child or something. That's your choice. You want to have a single child, it is perfectly okay. But the needs of a single child are different from the needs of a child who has got siblings or lives in a joint family where there are cousins and uncles and aunts and all that. So if there is a nuclear family, father, mother and one child, the needs of that child are going to be different. That child can grow up as healthy, as you know, good holistic development and everything, provided you cater to the specific needs of that child. So there are certain things which that child misses out on for not having siblings or not having other children in the house. Two of them which I find are of greater significance. One is the ability to be able to share, give and take, you know, negotiate, bargain, give out something, take something. That is something that you learn with your siblings. So if I get a birthday present which is exclusively mine, but my brother comes and says, I want to play with it. Initially, what do? I say, no, this is my present, I will not give you. After a little while, I realize that my brother is not sharing his chocolates with me. Or he is refusing to play with me because I am not sharing my car with him. So then I think it over, what is better? I think it better let him, you know, have that thing. Or I will say, last time in your birthday you had got that done, you didn't share with me. If you share that, then I will share this. So he says, okay, that done has anyway become old and it is broken down, so it doesn't matter. So he also learns. He says, I'll give you that old gun, not the new one, but you give me the gun. See, this is what we need to learn when we are adults, no? When we talk about negotiations, we talk about deals, we talk about corporate life and all these things. This is where the foundation is coming from. But if a single child gets a gift, it is his. And that's it. He doesn't need to know how to share and what it means to share and things of that sort. The second area which I find of significance is to be able to express emotions. See, a child expresses emotions much more freely with other children for the simple reason that elders always suppress emotions. If a child goes out to play and somebody comes and snatches away his ball, a little bigger ball, if he comes back to the class and starts crying to the teacher saying, you know, Rahul took away my ball, what does teacher do? Tell me. Don't come to me with all this problem. Shut up and don't cry like a sissy or a girl. Come, we are starting history class. Open your book, sit down. So even there he wanted to bring out his emotions, to express it, to learn how to manage it. It is reversed, it is suppressed. Maybe he goes back home and he is a single child, his nuclear family, maybe daddy, mummy, both are working, they come back late, they are tired, 8 o'clock in the night. Daddy comes home and he says, he thinks daddy big hero of mine and I can, you know, seek him as my rescuer. So this Rahul, I can teach him a lesson or something. So he goes very happily to daddy and said, "Daddy, daddy, you know, in today that Rahul took away my ball in the recess. Don't bother me with all these stupid things. I'm busy. I've got work to do and this and that's the end of the story." So normally what used to happen was, this was common, that it used to happen everywhere. But children had two people with whom they could share. One was inevitably some old grandfather, grandmother, somebody who is not hurried up, you know, who's got all the time in the world, so he would go and probably land up in the lap of Ajji and start giving the whole story. Ajji, Ajji doesn't understand head or tail of what he's talking about, but she would give him that solace, so he knows how to express, bring out his emotions. The other option is to go to a brother or sister or something. Whether that person agrees, doesn't agree, but you have somebody with whom you can communicate. At times you will even notice if there are siblings, you know, playing around at home. One is going on jabbering away about what happened in school, and the other one is busy playing, not even listening to him. But the purpose is still being achieved, because there is somebody right here in my house who belongs to me, who is my brother, sister, and I am saying it at the end of it is happy that he has poured out everything to him. So I am just giving you this as two examples to show you that there are a lot of areas in which children who are single children being brought up in an adult world with no other child, either their own sibling or a cousin or